I'm Kenny Sears, and I play the fiddle, sing a little bit, and I've been with the Time Jumpers since the beginning in 1998 when we started. First playing in the dressing room over at the Grand Ole Opry, and we decided that we would put something together and have some fun, and we found a station in and started playing there. It was 1998. I have so many favorites, and I have a favorite probably, or at least two or three favorites for every genre, something. For what we're doing with the Time Jumpers, I would have to say Bob Wills and the Texas Playboys, because they really are the ones that started playing big band music with stringed instruments. And that's what we're doing all these years later. Of course, Spade Cooley, there's so many that I could name, but I've always been partial to Bob Wills and the Texas Playboys. One interesting fact that the fans may not know about me is that I don't play golf, I don't watch sports on TV, I don't hunt and fish, I do woodworking. I like to build anything, but mostly the intricate kind of woodworking. For example, I've built my own fiddle. I like that kind of tedious woodworking. I spent 200 hours building the fiddle, so that takes up all the golf time.
I can't wait to get back to my San Antonio Rose.
My San Antonio Rose was actually the first song we recorded when we started this project back in 2014. Dawn sung it, of course, and she was not totally happy with all of the lines, which was quite unusual for her, but she was pretty sick at the time. And what's normal is that singers come back in and they get another shot at it once the tracks are all done and they fix whatever needs fixing. But she lost her voice and got too sick to sing before she could do that. And we talked about it, Vince and I, and we didn't want to lose the track because it was a good arrangement and all that. So I came in and gave it a shot at singing it. And I didn't get all the lines either. It was not the right key for all of the lines. Some were a little bit too low. So we got to exploring the possibilities and realized that the lines that she had gotten were the lines I didn't, and the lines that I got happened to be the lines that she didn't. So we put the two together and made a duet. We didn't intend for it to be that way, but it turned out that way, and it was a natural thing to do because we had done a duet together like that on the last album, and so that's how that song came about, the way it is. The song I wrote, This Heartache, was more a therapy session for myself. We all have blue days when we lose a soulmate, and I was having one of those. I kept thinking, well, this heartache is just more than this heart can take. And the more I got to fooling with that, I thought, well, I'll write this down, because my grief counselor told me to do that. I thought, I'll write this down and get rid of it so I can go do something a little more pleasant. And as I started writing, it started looking more like a song. And so I thought, well, I need to make this into a song. And probably should be a 4/4 country shuffle, because that's what Dawn loved. And so that's how that came about. It was a therapy session for myself. And so I wrote that and brought it in, and the guys thought we should record it, so we did.
My nights are filled with pain.